got a question.
Hold on.
What's your question real quick?
So, now, God and everybody was way back in BCs, way before they were the first mankind and all that. How did they get the words to put in the Bible from that far back? Who actually put these words?
Who wrote the Bible?
For us to know that they real.
Who wrote the Bible? For us to know that it's real, okay.
Yeah. Because if you notice, over the years, the Bible had extended.
Okay, more books have added to the Bible, more prophets have been added to the Bible.
How
I'll show you how. Give me Hosea chapter 12 and verse 10.
How they know that this is his word?
Okay, you got to listen.
That's
now.
Like if I was
now, I want, you to listen to the answer. You asked a question. It's a good question. A lot of our people ask that question. But you got to understand, this is how God deals. This is how God shows his word on the earth. God is not going to jump down and tell you nothing.
Right. So
because if he did come down, the way our people live, he will put them to death immediately. So watch this. Read that. I'm going to show you.
This is the book of Hosea.
And we did it back with the black man. Because this all going to tie together. How the prophets was black that wrote the Bible. And they wrote the Bible for us. It's our history book. Read.
Excuse me. This is the book of Hosea chapter 12 and verse 10.
Yeah, read that.
I have also spoken by the prophet.
That God said, listen, don't get distracted, sis. Watch this. God said he spoke by the prophets. Now, I want to ask you, who are the prophets of the Bible? Sis, pay attention. You asked the question. Who are the prophets of this Bible? Who are the prophets? Name them. You know, yeah, who the prophets of the Bible?
I don't even know the Bible.
You don't know. Okay, you don't know the Bible. So that's a good question. So watch this. Amos 2 and 11.
You know what?
This is the prophets in the Bible.
I don't believe in anything that's written after the fact. Right, because I don't, to be honest, I believe in a higher power. I believe in God. But I don't believe in a church because they say that the church is wrong. But guess what?
The Bible agrees with what you say, but watch this. Read that.
That's what I'm saying. So you're able to praise and talk
this
God.
This is the book
God
of Amos,
anywhere on earth.
Chapter 2.
I want you to pay attention.
This is the book of Amos, chapter 2 and verse 11. And I raise up of your sons.
Of your sons. God is telling us of the Israelite sons. If you're on this side, are you on this side right here? I'm asking you a question. I'm dealing with the question. Are you on this side? You blacks, Hispanics, and Native Americans. That's who we out here to teach. Which one are you?
All three.
All three?
Yep.
So which one is your father?
My father's Mexican.
Okay. So you will come from the tribe of Issachar, according to the sign.
Bring it up.
According to the Bible. Read that. I'm going to show you. Your forefathers is prophets in the Bible that was used to help push this Bible. Read.
Okay, but those
and I raise up of your sons for prophets.
Read.
And of your young men for Nazarites.
Read. Let's see who he's talking to. Read.
It is not even thus, O ye children of Israel.
So our forefathers is the one that put this book together by the inspiration of the Most High God. It wasn't no wicked man that was just, let me write a book. Let me just make up some stuff about, black people, let's say we're going to go into slavery about 2,000 years from now. And we're going to go into slavery for doing these things. No, God told us this.
Okay.
Read that. Okay, Exodus 31,
okay,
right.
But this is the thing. This is my thing, right? So if you were to pass away and somebody do a documentary on you, no one really knows you. Like
guess
that,
what?
Like every moment, every minute of your life to actually make an actual true documentary, some things in your documentary is gonna be lies. So
you said the Bible is lies?
Some might be.
So you gotta show me in the Bible where it didn't lie.
No, I'm saying some might be.
Read that. After this, we're gonna show you in the Bible curses that happened to us, and I want you to show me which one was a lie. Read this though.
This is the book of Exodus chapter 31 and verse 18.
Uh-huh.
And he gave unto Moses.
So God gave unto Moses, read.
When he had made an ending of communion with him upon Mount Sinai.
Read.
Testimonies,
read.
Tables of stone.
And who wrote on that stone? I want you to pay attention, sister. What's your name, by the way?
Kenya.
Kenya, okay, watch this.
Written.
Written by who?
With the finger.
With the finger of who?
God.
Who wrote the Bible?
How we know that?
Who here is proof. Go to Deuteronomy 28. Now we're going to get more proof of who wrote the Bible. Deuteronomy 28 and 68. I'm going to show you the most basic curse God put up. This is the original version right here. Read that. Pay attention. I want you to listen, King. Listen to this. Watch. 28:68. Watch. I want you to listen to what God said was going to happen to us thousands of years ago. Read this.
Okay,
I want you to pay attention. Read.
Chapter 28, verse 68.
Read.
And the Lord shall bring thee.
And God told us he was going to bring us into what?
Into Egypt again.
Into Egypt. When we was in Egypt, we was in slavery.
Look,
when you even look at the, hieroglyphics? Hieroglyphics. In Egypt, it show Israelites in slavery. I want y'all to pay attention. This is very easy and basic to understand. But a lot of our people cannot get it because they have not applied the laws of God. They have not humbled themselves down to the scriptures. But when the white man comes and teach his stuff, they believe it, because believe it or not, what you're saying comes from them.
Right, the white man wrote that book.
The white man did not write this book.
Yes, he did.
Because if he did, why would he say Christ is a black man in a Bible?
That's right.
Show me the image of white Jesus in the Bible. Show it to me. Show it to me right now. You can't do it. Read.
Exactly.
They didn't upgrade nothing. You have not read. You have not read. Read.
You said it's a new edition.
And the Lord shall bring thee into Egypt again.
So God said he was going to bring us into Egypt again. Meaning what? Slavery. How was we going to go? So you got to examine. Where's that sign at? We went into slavery on slave ships. I want that for the slave chart. We went into slavery on slave ships. This is how we went into slavery. We didn't go into slavery no other way. They brought us over from the west coast of Africa. And not only from there, all over Africa, and brought us here.
Okay, tell me, who was the first slave owner?
Bring it out.
You can't disprove this book. It's impossible.
No, I'm saying, who was the first slave owner?
But our people don't want to apply the laws of God. So they make up anything.
It wasn't the white man.
So they don't have to do what the Bible say do. That's very basic. Prove why we getting shot down in the street. Show me why that's happening. Why are we going to slavery? Tell me that.
You said what?
Why are we going to slavery?
Who put us in slavery?
The white man.
The white man?
Right.
Why?
Let me get on this.
Are you sure?
Why? Who put us in slavery?
Are you sure?
Who put us in slavery?
Do you know the Europeans and the Ethiopians? They the ones that actually started the slavery before the white people.
This is the book of Deuteronomy, chapter 28.
My sisters don't want to hear it. They want to tell you. They don't want to hear the word of God.
Therefore shall they serve thy enemy.
So God told us, after we get on them slave ships, the scripture we just read, and get sent all the way over here to America, to a land we have never been on, God said we was going to serve our enemies. When we got off the slave ships, did we own anything?
That's right.
No. When the white man came over here in 1492 and conquered the Hispanics, they took everything for them. They had to go to them to get their bread now. They had to go to them to get their wood now. They forced them to build their cathedral.
That's right.
In the Dominican Republic. Come on now. What's your question?
You didn't think about it? This is actually supposed to happen. Here's the lights and everything. This is the playground. Okay, choose your faith. What you gonna do? With the liquor store, the drugs, that's why shooting going on.
Right.
Going on because they put, this is programmed to do that.
Right, I wanna read this.
Which the Lord shall send against thee.
So it's telling you who sent the white man against us. The Lord. The Lord sent the white man against us because the black woman never wants to obey the order that God set up.
That's right.
This is one of the reasons God sent them against us.
Right.
You got the black man going crazy, doing the drugs, out of his mind, out of control, murdering his own people. And you got the black woman doing the ways of Eve, trying to be over the black man, trying to rule.
That's right.
This is why we keep going into slavery.
Right, right.
This is not our first slavery. We was in Egypt, we left out of there. He's telling us we're gonna go back if we disobey God's call.
Bring it out.
Then we in Assyrian captivity, we in Babylon, we in the Greeks, we in Rome. Why do we keep going to slavery?
That's right.
Bring it out.
Because we have disobeyed the laws of God.
We used to scream black power while Haram was pushed. But at the end of the day, nothing's in vain. IUIC has been given a vision. The tents of Judah has risen. Many has attempted the mission, minor murmuring, omitting, and missing the mark. Just reading that he had the flame of fire in his eyes gave us the spark. We on Paul's mission. We out on the road, purple and gold. From Mexico, Cuba, Haiti, Ghana, Sierra Leone. 144,000 boots banging, concrete crackling. These are how our men repented at heart. The scriptures is proof. IUIC, we deliver the truth.